Valence bond theory. Let's use the valence bond theory to explain the hybridization that must occur to result in the trigonal planar arrangement. Let's look at the example boron trifluoride and trying to understand this new type of hybridization. In the case of the molecule boron trifluoride, we find that boron trifluoride is an exception to the octet rule in that boron, being a small molecule, can form stable compounds with only 6 valence electrons. So this is the Lewis structure that we expect to see with boron trifluoride. And so on the central atom, we only have 3 regions of high electron density. All of those regions are bonding pairs of electrons. And according to the Vesper theory, whenever we have 3 regions of high electron density, those electrons arrange themselves in space as far apart as possible, giving the trigonal planar type of geometry. And so the molecule looks something like this. Okay, and so we'd like to understand how we can hybridize the atomic orbitals on boron to end up with such an arrangement. So let's take a closer look at the pure atomic orbitals on boron. Boron has 3 valence electrons, and the electron configuration on boron as an individual isolated atom is 2s2, 2p1. That's the electron configuration for the valence shell of boron. Now, if we have 3 bonding regions and they're all arranged in space as far apart as possible, what we find is the hybridization that occurs is 3 new hybrid orbitals are formed. They're formed from the mixing of one of the 2s and the 1 2s, I should say, and 2 of the 2p's to give a new hybrid orbitals called sp2. They're called sp2 again because it's the mixing of these 3 atomic orbitals. Since we only mix 3 of the available 4, we're left with 1p orbital that is still in its pure atomic form. Okay then, so in this case, once we've mixed, the 3 valence electrons fall into those 3 degenerate shapes. And so if we look back here, the 3, the S and the 2Ps combine to form these 3 new atomic orbitals called sp2. Those sp2 orbitals arrange themselves in space as far apart as possible, of course, according to the predicted shape from the linear combination of the atomic orbitals, such that we end up with this trigonal planar electronic geometry. So we can then imagine that this is an sp2 orbital, an sp2 orbital, an sp2 orbital, and then the fluorine comes and one of the empty p orbitals, excuse me, not empty, but a p orbital that has only 1 valence electron, because remember the electron configuration for fluorine is 2s2, 2p5. One of our p orbitals has just 1 electron available for bonding, will come head on to the sp2 and form the covalent bond there. So in this case, we form 3 sigma bonds from head on overlap of the sp2 hybrid orbital on the central atom of borane and the 2p pure atomic orbital on the fluorine to form the 3 sigma bonds. And in this case, and in every case in which we have the trigonal planar electronic geometry, we're going to expect that the hybridization on the central atom to allow for this particular electronic geometry, and in this case also molecular geometry, is going to be sp2 hybridization.